Mr. Blanche from DrawScope sent me a DrawScope so I could play around with it, see what I thought, and make a review on it. So the DrawScope is a tool that you can use for drawing or painting. This is what it comes in, a tube, and you can see it has reference that you can use with painting or if you're drawing with color, for color, and then it also has a value scale on it as well and instructions on how you can use it. Inside, it comes in a velvet pouch. And this is the DrawScope. It comes with a string so you can wear it around your neck when you're working, and there's also measurements on that so you can use that as a tool for measuring. And so the DrawScope, what it has two mirrors inside it. So you look through here, and so using these two mirrors, you can project what you're seeing on your canvas or paper, and your brain superimposes them on top of it. So you're literally projecting the image onto your canvas or paper. And while it is projecting the image onto your canvas or paper, this tool isn't used for, or at least I, playing around with it, I don't think you could use it for tracing. It's not like using a projector and tracing. The way that it works with projecting it, it's more something that helps you correct your drawing either with literally the drawing or color or value. And so I went out plein air painting, and that's the first time that I used this. So what I did was I found a spot that I wanted to paint, and I found an interesting scene of this hill with all these tall grasses and these interesting rocks. And so I set up my easel and I put my panel on my easel and kind of figured out ish like what I wanted to work on. And so I use this to get more specific with that. So it's a bit of a learning curve I found using this, because it's how your brain is superimposing the two images of what you are wanting to paint and then your canvas or panel or paper or whatever. But so how you do it is you hold it up to one eye and you're looking through the DrawScope eye is looking at the scene that you want to be painting, and then your free eye is looking at your canvas or panel or paper or whatever. And the mirrors in there is superimposing that onto the paper or canvas. And there's also this button here that you can push back and forth that kind of helps adjust if you need to get the scene to like go on top of your canvas. So with one eye, you're looking at your scene, the other eye, you're looking at your canvas, and it's putting the two images on top of each other. And so the tricky part is getting these two eyes to be equally looking at the landscape and your canvas. And so it's not, I found using this, it's not something where I put it up really quick and take it down and I've like seen what I needed to see. But getting my brain to do that, I have to hold it up for maybe 20 seconds for my brain to like figure it out. But it's cool. It's really cool because it does work. It's pulling the image onto your canvas. And so using this for this situation with my plein air painting, I figured out how exactly I wanted to crop my image, and so I adjusted my easel a little bit and then also myself from where I was standing to get everything to match up how I wanted it to match up and like crop the image. And this is working sight size as well, so it's the sight size method of having your setup and painting it. And so once I found my spot and how I wanted to crop the image, I mixed up a shadow color and I started just laying in really simple drawing of this. So using the, like finding the horizon line and the rocks and the path going up. And so I would keep pulling this out when I was working on like the basic drawing for it. And this was really helpful to do that, so I could see matching it up if maybe I made the rocks too big or up too high, that this was a really nice tool for correcting. And then I put the drawing scope away and I just started working on my painting then. So getting like the basic values in and doing like a full pass over everything so I could work everything up together. And I took a break and then I came back out and was starting to make everything more and more specific with it. And as I was nearing the end of the painting then, I pulled this out to see if I could see if I did anything weird like drawing wise or anything like that, that I could use this to correct it. So doing the same thing where I hold it up and I'm looking with one eye, the other eye is open too, that I'm looking at my canvas. And I found now that my painting is really developed. It's not just a blank canvas, and it's not just a blank canvas with just like a few lines on it, that it was harder for me to keep both of those images equal. It seemed like for whatever reason that my brain either wanted to like really focus on the free eye so that the painting was really pronounced, and then the DrawScope eye looking at the scene was like very, very, very light, too light to actually look to make judgments off of. Or the reverse would happen where I'd be, this eye would be more focused. And so then the painting was really hard to see. So with the painting being more developed, I had to hold up the DrawScope and look through it longer. And as it was like, as I was switching focus from my eye, so I'd be focusing here, and then I would like try and start focusing on the landscape. And there would be a point when it was switching focus where I could see both of the painting and the scene equally. That's where I could, that's where this was helpful, and it was doing what it needed to do. It was still confusing though at this point, where I couldn't really use it to like work out drawing errors. And I think that's because that would be at this point in the painting really minute. But what this was really helpful for was at this point with the developed painting was value and then also color. So this made it really obvious that I had kind of underemphasized some color things. So in the rocks and in the tall grass, there was this strong orange that made it really obvious using the draw scope. So then I put the draw scope away and I mixed up that bright orange and put it on my painting, and it like really made the painting sing and had this like punch of color in it that was lacking before. So when I was working on this painting, it was during a plein air event, and then I actually won second place for this painting. Yay! Okay, so then I brought the DrawScope home, and so I was going to use it for my studio work and see how it held up with that. And so this painting that I am currently working on, it's not sight size, it's using comparative measuring. And so again, I couldn't use this for the drawing then, because that wouldn't make sense since it's not sight size, but I could use it for value and color. So all in all, I think this is a pretty cool tool. I like it. It's gonna stay in my plein air bag. I do work sight size when I do plein air, so I like being able to pull this out and kind of see like cropping. And I also liked how I could pull it out at the end and check color and value, especially with plein air painting. It's something that I work on for like 2 or 3 hours and then I'm done with the painting. So it's nice that instead of like me like staying there and like contemplating the painting for a while and then I might figure out like, oh, I could push color or maybe the values are a bit off, that this is like a really fast, handy tool. So I like it for that reason. I think also when I'm working in my studio and I've got like a still life setup or something like that, that this will be nice, like figuring out how to place objects on my canvas and like using it for kind of like planning out composition. But if you're interested and you wanna try this out, the company is called DrawScope, and I'll put a link in the description box below for their website. They also do a good job on their website explaining exactly how like your brain is like flipping these images together.